for over 400 years. The armies of Kairos the Overlord have swept across the known world. All who stood against them fell before their might. Even the Archons, women and men of immense power, were forced to kneel, chained to the Overlord's will. Now Kairos's final conquest has come to our corner of the world, and two of the Overlord's armies compete for the honor of taking our lands. The elite disfavored, and the teeming horde of the Scarlet Chorus. The voices of Narat, spymaster and Archon of Secrets, guides the fierce and undisciplined masses of the Scarlet Chorus. With each battle, the Scarlet Chorus grows stronger as the defeated are given a simple choice. Serve or die. Graven Ash, Archon of War and the Overlord's most loyal general, leads the disfavored. Though small in number, Kairos's ironclad legion has never met true defeat in open battle. Watching over the two generals is Tunon, the Adjudicator, Archon of Justice, eldest of Kairos's minions. Tunon brings Kairos's laws to newly conquered lands, aided by the Fatebinders, judges and executioners of the Overlord's laws. You were among the youngest of the court of Fatebinders when Kairos's armies came to our lands. How could we have known that the fate of thousands would rest in your hands?
My wounds are slowing me down. I need rest.
Have a look here.
To battle! Flop! I'll just hold on to this.
That wasn't so hard.
All the world has fallen to Kairos, and now the Overlord's eye is on the Tears, our home. The last corner of the world free of Kairos's reign. Two armies, the Disfavored and the Scarlet Chorus, march south from the Northern Empire, the last realm to fall to Kairos a century prior. In the early days of 428, Kairos's armies arrive at the Gates of Judgment, the mountainous border that we Tearsmen so long believed unassailable. Unable to agree on a unified plan of defense, the various leaders of the Tears sit and wait for each other to deal with the conquerors. Until it's too late. The year is 431, and Kairos's invasion has shattered all major opposition in the Tiers. The Younger Realms, the Bastard Tier, the Free Cities. All who defied Kairos lay broken by battle, or bowed in surrender. The two armies of the Overlord, the Disfavored and the Scarlet Chorus, now control our lands. But our will is not yet extinguished. Not entirely. In the Valley of Vendrian's Well, those of us unwilling to bow to Kairos have banded together in defiance. Violating an oath of surrender from 2 years prior, we have staged a bloody uprising, murdering the Disfavored and Scarlet Chorus garrison in a midnight assault. With their main forces spread across the Tiers, the Disfavored and Scarlet Chorus redeploy to Vendrian's Well to crush the resistance, but months pass with no definitive battle. As disagreement and discord paralyze the Archons, we bide our time and wait for our message of insurrection to spread across the Tiers. The Overlord is not amused, and Kairos has one message for the Archons: crush the Oathbreakers or die. Kairos backs this threat with an edict, a magical commandment that can slay all in the valley should the order be ignored. The honor of proclaiming this edict fell to you. Sent across the mountains to Vendrian's Well, you carry the Overlord's edict to read before the Archons. As you finally make your way through the winding mountain passes into the valley, the ground trembles, and Kairos's magic seals the way behind you. You are trapped in Vendrian's Well, with Kairos's armies and the Oathbreakers. The only way to survive is to fulfill the terms of the Overlord's edict, in any way that you can.
Right. Right. Sorry, I can't.
Not dead yet.
To battle! I got it. Will do. Right. Can't do that. I got it. Will do. On it.
Take that!
Die!
Right. Can't do that.
Try and catch me, worm. Finder. You're here at last. Here to join me in putting these cowards out of their misery.
Heads up, we have company.
Hope you face it.
Can't do that. Can't do that.
I can tell you didn't spend the conquest in a diplomat's tent. I'm Verse, by the way. But there are more important things to take care of than introductions. Those Vendrian guard we killed didn't come alone. My guess? The Vendrian guard are testing our strength in battle. A Scarlet Fury, one of the elite killers of our ignoble gang. You'll see more than a few of us around camp, but don't let that fool you. We're a rare breed. Most of the soldiers in the Scarlet Chorus are little more than farmers and children armed with rusted forks. The voices of Narat called his best fighters to this siege. There must be something important about Vendrian's well, though don't ask me what. Eager! I like that. Before we go, you might search among the remains of our fallen comrades. Wherever they're bound, I doubt they'll miss their boots, much less any rings or any useful iron they might be clutching. No reason to pity the fallen. Before long, we might wish we'd joined them here.
For the voices of Narat!
Troubling.
Sorry, I can't.